you know, these times when you get as strong as you can with armor, and you're just like, I'm too weak. I'm just fucking too weak. And you were like, I need runes, but for rune, only rune form I know from YouTube is that gives me like 2,500k per 30 seconds. Who needs that? Yeah, that's what I feel sometimes. And I bet some of you do too. So today, I'm gonna show you a rune form for late game, because late game is when you actually need runes. Early game, it's pretty chill, to be honest. For late game. So, there are some requirements that you'll meet, and I'll tell you in a second. So, if you want to get mega runes, endless runes, super fast, and super efficient without fighting any bosses or enemies, then this is the right video for you. You'll get over 100k for doing nothing in 3 minutes. And I'm speaking the complete truth. There's some things you'll need and some things we suggest. So if you enjoy the video, why not leave a like, comment, share, subscribe, and turn on notifications to never miss an upload again. Good. And now let's get to the requirements. So, map requirements. You will have to defeat Radahn. Or you don't, but if you don't, this glitch will not even work as good. Won't even work half as good. So, defeat Radahn. Get through all the lifts into the ice area. Have torrent. That is the map requirements. Next requirements. You need to have
always.
You know what, I can show you my inventory. Yeah, bye. Equipment. You'll need a torch. Not a sentry's torch, but a normal torch. Optional. You'll need big great arrows, but I'll show you where you can get them. For after the glitch, it's no problem. Before the glitch, you'll need, that's just about 10k runes before the glitch, so you can actually start. Keep that in mind. But all you need is gold pick with alpha, gold scrab, blind great ball, great arrow. That's all you need at that part. So then all you need is from quests is, I do suggest at the beginning, you'll meet Vary at the first step. I do really suggest that you do his quest line up to where he gives you an item. This one right here, pure blood knight metal. So all the way you'll be able to collect Heroes Road 2, which should give you about 25k runes, if I'm not wrong. And you'll get the rune glitch, of course. So let's get straight into it. Let's get straight into it. From here on, you need to know a couple of things. In this video, I'll be showing you how to get the mega OP tactic that will be in the ice area. I'll be showing you how to get the stuff you need for the tactic and explaining a little about it and why it's so OP. So, first thing you need to know, you need to have access to the ice area. Three big points you need. You have the lifts, the grand lift of Dectus, search up a guide online on how to unlock it. Then go up here and you can just do all this stuff, technically. But the main point is that you go straight down here, unlock the grace, go up here, do a stop and take the grace, very important. Then go here, defeat a Draconic Teal Tree Sentinel, make your way through, defeat a Purtified Spirit, defeat the first Elden Lord, defeat Omen the King, and I think one more boss somewhere. After that, you'll get locations on how to get here. Go through here, and you'll need the next. You'll get, after defeat Omen the King, the medallion for here. Go up here, make your way through, grind as much as you want, and just have fun in general over here. After you have some fun, go up here, defeat a boss, and get the right half of the secret medallion. And over here is pretty early game, the left hand is right over here. It's like a pot, and the pot is like hidden as a guy. So, you got all that, good, then you're ready to start. So, now that you have access to all these areas, which quests do you need to have unlocked? Optional. I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure you don't need it. But I'll still do it before you do this. Is Kil'Radan at his festival. Over here, in this area, you should go up in the festival and kill him. Not sure if it's necessary, but I really do suggest it. Good. Next thing you need to have processed with the quest of NPCs you meet first at the new first step. The NPC Vary, you'll meet there, you need to have done his quest line to the point up where you do get like this little talisman that brings you to Mog. I guess you could do it without, but you would really not be ready. If you did do that yet, don't do it, please. Okay. Once you got all this, and you're up here, and you got both halves of the secret medallion, and you go up here, and just you go right north. There is a big drop here, so be careful. But except that, go right north, dodge this, go keep going north. You'll see a city, you'll see a grace point, and get this grace point. From then on, just go right over here, and set yourselves a waypoint right over there. This will be the easiest way to get there, and the safest way, not the fastest way. Just keep that in mind. So, before we go into the ice area, let's go to the merchant you secured the grace at. For this, you need to do it the most efficient, 100% you'll need a ball. To do it the most efficient, you'll need a big ball. As example, that's why I suggest killing Radon to get his Lion Great Ball. It's awesome. You don't even need to have stats for it, it's just longer. Here normally is a merchant. I don't know why this Bellboy Hunter. I don't know why this guy appeared right here, but I'm not gonna fight against him. I don't have the will to do that right now. But normally there'll be a merchant sitting right in that house and he'll sell all bows, arrows you need. The big arrows I'm talking about, and that are these arrows, great arrows, and normal arrows, I guess, and some proper stuff to me. I don't know what that guy is, Bellbearing Hunter. You should have him, except you go into the area. Exactly. That was it. I forgot. I just read my notes. As soon. Why can't I use my mind? As soon as you use, like, the glitch to get, like, not glitch, but use a portal that I'll show you in a second, to get into the world you need to get, the dimension, that guy will appear there. So get enough before, make yourself strong enough to defeat him. I did this glitch about 3 times, he appeared late, but that is a glitch on my side, he'll appear the first time after you get into that dimension. So be very careful, please. But once you are here and you actually get the arrows and stuff, he won't be there first time. Don't be worried. Even though he doesn't seem as hard, he does some damage. But all of the big ghosts who do a lot of damage don't have a lot of health. And I can speak of experience. Okay, then as soon as you have the grace point here, let's start right here. If you really do need a more detailed guide, just tell me and I can probably lead you privately even. So, once you're here, you need to go towards point, jump on your horse. A little mention of Orphan little thing to mention worth is, if you didn't listen for the intro for some reason, I'll just mention it again. For this glitch to work perfectly, you will need gold pickle file foot and the talisman. They're both not required, but then it will be working at its maximum potential. They're not too hard to get. You'll find a guide how to get them easy, and I'll make guides too. So you just head straight here, do collect all the gold seed over there, and just keep going. You can jump down here. This should not be any kind of a problem. Be careful, there's a big baddie over there. He won't reach you. He won't do anything. Look at him. Cute little boy. Even if I'm standing still, he does not reach me. So just keep going. And even if he just for some reason because it's glitching, just go behind the spikes and then come around that big rock over here. Just keep going here. You can find a way over the rocks. You can go over like this or just go around it. Big point is that you come right to this corner right here, where it goes in, and this is where you have the waypoint marked. Right here. This is where you have it marked. Then, you need this big, like, giant thing or one of that holds. I don't know how it's gonna reach. I guess you can lure it to break this, and you'll get a lot of smithing stones. I do suggest it, but I didn't do it myself yet, so I can't really say anything about it. So you just keep going here. Now you need to be careful, there will be strong bears over there that can insta-kill you if you're not careful. But you can dodge them very, very easily. So you don't need to worry about that if you just follow me exactly. So you went up all walls with Corey. Now just drop down right next to that rock. Go here. Go over here. Can collect this food. I never found arrows loot here, and I'm kinda dumb. I know that. There's even hero runes. I should have known that in my own guide. That was very risky, though. Do not do that. But as soon as you're on that thingy, I'll just do it to show you again. Do not fall off like me because you're interested in what you get there. Do it carefully and not like me did yet. You go right here, and you see like the edge. Just jump off right here. And you'll be safe from the bears. Be careful, you will get despawned, and there will be a pretty strong NPC here. I even had my problems with him. But I killed him at the end, and after that I found a glitch that probably helps you makes life easier. You go over here, drop down, and just jump down the edge, and he'll jump right after you. You get his loot, it works, you get his runes, and he's dead, and the portal will activate. After you did that, examine. And go through the portal. It's gonna show you off the map where you are now. I put it way down, but you set it right here. You went down this path, went up this rock, jumped down there, went here, and it's the safest way possible. Then you travel to this location. I did not include this because I thought you probably have a torch. If not, doesn't matter. I'll even do it without torch just to show you. It's with a torch, it just is better, but you could just also follow the light down here. There will be a little flickering and you'll be right out of the cave already. Be careful here, follow exactly my steps and go on. Do not try to jump down, you will just die. Just keep going, you can collect some nice plants you need later on. Then jump down right here, drop down here, and jump down here. Now you'll be at this grace point. Activate the grace point and if you need to, rest. So, we have two farms here. The first one is this farm. You can kill them for 2,500 each if you one-hit them. This is an extremely good way of farming. If you don't one-hit them, it's not. Be careful. As soon as you go over this rock ledge, you will get attacked by them. You see, as soon as I go over, now I'm in risk zone. They can now officially attack me. Behind, it happened to me before here. Behind this line, I never saw anybody actually get aggroed by them. Even if I like jump around. Do my thing and just being a complete idiot. Nothing happens how you see. So, but that is only the like bad glitch I'll call. This is where you'll need your stuff. Equip your bow, equip your bolts. You see that big bird thing? You know, Big Bird Feed is very strong, give you 10k roundabout if you don't have any extras. Give you 17 per roundabout if you have a gold pickled foot and that talisman. So, you're gonna pick out your bow, you're gonna double wield it if you don't have the stats, and not very important. You wait for it to come back, it won't, don't risk it because you want all the time you can get. You stand here, be ready, and as soon as it passes that tree, you'll either go pick a foul foot and do exactly what I'll do. So you need to be careful. I do really suggest a big bow. A small bow will work, but you have so less range, it will go very hard, and I don't know if it's worth it. So you Q target it, and then you just start, as soon as it's near the tree, shooting it. As soon as you shoot it, either you'll hit it or you'll lure it. Let me just eat this real quick. I forgot. Don't forget like me. Shoot it again, and it will jump at you, fall down, give you 70k ruin. You'll have a gold pickle foot for exactly 3 minutes, and now just do it as fast as you can and hit him. This was just an example to show you, if you go down to rest too fast, he won't actually aggro you, so don't do that. As soon as he jumps, you can turn around and go. And that were exactly 3 minutes. So be careful, sometimes it can get stuck if you shoot it at around time as me. So I had like about 30 seconds of waste altogether in there, but I could have made more runes. So the normal is without any extras, you'll make about 80k runes. With only gold, you'll make about 100k runes. With gold and scrap, you can make from, if you're bad like me, 100k, but 250k runes per 3 minutes. If that is not good, then I do not know what is. And it's that simple. You don't need to fight any boss, not anything. It's just that simple. Matter of fact, you don't need to fight anything, except the invader, of course. You need to fight the invader. No, you don't even need to fight him. You can just jump off the edge and he'll jump right after you, how I explained. So this method is completely fight free. It takes no effort. It's easy, and it can give you millions of runes if you actually work for it. And along the way here, you'll get hero rune to. And Lord Runes gives you 50k, I think this gives you that 30 to 25k. So that is another extra you'll get the first time you do this. So it's really worth it, trust me. You can do it as much as you want, it will never stop. It's not kind of glitching because it's a mechanic of the game that here aggroes you. You won't lose any sight of grace, so you can always come back. It's after, you don't need to, how I said, you don't need to defeat any boss. It's easy. All you need to do is do what I told you at the beginning. Go past here, go up here, go up here, go there, go to a teleporter, go through the teleporter. You'll be here, go down the tunnel, fall into way, and you'll be there. But I explained that at the beginning. So, that is me, OutGamers, with the guide. I hope this rune farm will help you, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, why not leave a like, subscribe, and all that comes with it. I really do appreciate all of you. How I said, I hope it helped. If not, don't feel free to leave me any comments about any guide you need, or that it's not working, what the problem is, or if you don't know, then I'll be trying to fix it. I'll surely be making more guides, so how I said, if you have any suggestions, leave them in the comment, and it's Orc Plays Out. See you in the next time, gamers.